where are you going? The morning bell ain't rung yet. Get back to sleep.
I want to beat the other fellas to the street. I don't want anyone to see ya. I ain't been walking so good.
You quit your griping. You know how many fellas fake a limp to sympathy? That bum leg of yours is a gold mine.
Someone gets the idea. I can't make it on my own. They'll lock me up in the refuge for good. Be a pal, Jack. Help me down. Whoa!
Hey, you want to bust the other leg too?
No. I want to go down.
You'll be down there soon enough. Take a moment. And drink in my penthouse. High above the stinking streets of New York.
You're crazy.
Why? Because I like a breath of fresh air. I like seeing the sky and the stars.
You're seeing stars, all right.
Them streets down there, they suck the life right out of my old man. Years of rotten jobs stomped on by bosses. And when they finally broke him, they just tossed him to the curb like yesterday's paper. And they ain't doing that to me.
But everyone wants to come here.
New York's fine for those who can afford it. Big strong door and lock it out. But I tell you, Crutchy, there's a whole other way out there. So you keep your small life in a big city. Give me a big life in a small town. They say Fox is dying to get here. Me, I'm dying to get away to a little town now west that's speaking no. And while I ain't never been there, I can see it clear as day. If you want, I'll bet you you could see it too. Close your eyes, come with me. Where it's clean and green and pretty, and they made a city out of clay. Why the minute that you get there, folks will walk right up and say, welcome home, son, welcome home to Santa Fe. Chef of Sunday when you lie around all day. Soon your friends is more like family, and they's begging you to stay. Ain't that neat? Living sweet in Santa Fe.
You got folks there?
I ain't got no folks nowhere. You?
I don't need folks. I got friends.
Hey, how's about you come with me? Hey, no worries about no gimp leg in Santa Fe. You just hop on Palomino and you're riding style.
Yeah, feature me riding in style.
Hey, I bet if you want to clean in, you could toss that clutch for good.
Santa Fe, you can bet we won't let them bastards beat us. We won't beg. Life that's worth a living, and I'm gonna do my share. Work the land, chase the sun, swim the Ohio Grand just for fun.
Watch me stand, watch me run.
Hey. Hey. Don't you know that we's a family? Hey, now would I let you down? No way. Just hold on, kid, till that train makes Santa Fe. Yeah, time for dreaming's done. Hey, Racer, Henry, Albert, Elmer, Specs, get a move on, boys, them pipes don't sell themselves.
Thank you. you hard, Jack. Get a move on.
I was having the most beautiful dream. My lips are still tingling.
Ooh, a pretty girl.
A leg of lamb.
Hey, that's my cigar.
You'll steal another.
Hey, look, it's bath time at the zoo.
I thought that I'd surprise my mother. If you could find her,
where's you? From Bottle Alley to the harbor, there's easy pickings guaranteed.
Try any banker, bum or bob.
It's a crooked game we're playing, one we'll never lose. Rugged suckers don't mind paying just to get bad news.
And if I might carrying the band through it all, a mighty fine life, carrying the band that's up and tall. When that bell rings, we go very wishes, bees as green as fishes, sure be squashing dishes. What a fine life.
Step aside, Romeo. Nothing more concerns you here. Morning, miss. Can I interest you in the latest news?
The paper isn't out yet.
Oh, I would be delighted to deliver it to you personally.
I've got a headline for you. Cheeky boy gets nothing for his troubles.
Oh.
Back to the bin, slugger. You struck out.
Oh, I'm crushed.
Hey, Crutchy, what's your leg say? Gonna rain?
No rain. Oh, I'll be glad to clip on you.
And a bottle, this guy.
Yeah. Sells 50 papes a week all by itself.
I don't even live to sell papes. I got poisonality. It takes a smile that spreads like butter, the kind that turns the lady's head.
It takes an orphan with a stutter,
who's also blind
and mute
and dead.
Summer stinks and winter's freezing when you work outdoors. Start out spreading, end up sneezing, in between it falls. Divine life, carrying the band to the bars. Divination, tossing out the dreams of the bars. Tossing out the dreams of the
bars. Waiting to make me an ear,
I like to live in the
dance. Yeah.
pizza?
Yeah!
The trolley strike? Oh. Not again!
And these 3 weeks of the same story!
They're killing us with that snoozer!
Wait, step aside!
Dear me, what is that unpleasant aroma? I fear the sewers may have backed up during the night.
Or could it be
the Delancey brothers?
Hey, Oscar, word on the street says you and your brother beat up striking trolley workers for money.
So, it's honest work.
We're cracking the heads of defenseless workers.
Mm-mm. I take care of the guy that takes care of me.
Hey, ain't your father one of the strikers?
Well, I guess he didn't take care of me.
What's with the two lucky
cricks?
Hey, hey,
hey.
Nice move.
Yeah, like the one Jack Skunk said.
Yeah! One unfortunate day, you may find you got a bum game of your own. Now, how'd you like one of us picking on you? Maybe we should find out.
Wait till I get my hands on you!
You're gonna catch me first!
Line up, boys.
Morning, Weasel. Did you miss me?
The name's Wiesel.
Ain't that what I said? I'll take 100 papes and be on my way.
100 papes for the wise guys.
How's it going, Weasel?
At least call me mister.
Ooh, well, I'd call you sweetheart if you spot me 50 papes.
Drop the cash and move it along.
Oh, well, whatever happened to romance?
50 for the race. Next.
Good morning, Mr. Weiser.
50 papers for Crutchy. Have a look at this. A new kid.
I'm new too.
Don't worry, kid. It rubs right off.
I'll take 20 newspapers, please.
20 newspapers for 20 papers for the new kid. Let's see the dime.
Oh, I'll pay when I sell them.
Funny, kid. Come on. Cash up front.
But whatever I don't sell, you buy back, right?
Certainly. And every time you lose a tooth, I'll put a penny under your pillow. This kid's a riot. Come on, cough up the cash or blow. Come on, move it along. Specs, let me see your money.
Yeah, you have a very interesting face. Ever think about moving pictures?
Do you think I could?
Sure, buy a ticket. They let anyone in.
Sorry, excuse me. I paid for 20, but you gave me 19.
You seen how nice I was to this new kid? And what did I get for my civility? Ungrounded accusations?
I just want what I paid for.
He said beat it.
Hey, no, he's right, Weasel. He gave you 19. Hey, I'm sure it was an honest mistake on account of Oscar can count to 20 with the shoes on.
Now take a hike.
All right, give the no kid 50 more papes.
No, I don't want more papes.
What?
What kind of newsie don't want more papes?
I'm no charity case. I don't even know you.
His name's Jack.
Yeah, this here is the famous Jack Kelly. He once escaped jail on the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage, made all the papers.
How old are you, kid?
I'm 10. Almost.
If anybody asks, you're 7. Youngest sells more papers, and if we're gonna be partners, then I...
Who said we want a partner?
Selling with Jack is the chance of a lifetime. You learn from him, you learn from the best.
If he's the best, what's he need with me?
Because you've got a little brother and I don't. Look, that puss could easily sell 1,000 papes a week. Now look, that kid. Oh, we're gonna make millions!
This is my brother, Dave. Hi, Wes.
Hey, nice to meet you, Dave. You might two bits come off the top, but everything else, 70-30.
50-50. We're trying to pass on a little kid.
Whoa. 60-40, and that's my final offer.
Deal.
That's disgusting.
It's just doing business. Nosies, hit the streets!
The sun is up, the headline sticks, and this kid ain't getting any younger.
Gentlemen, the world is in trouble. Our circulation is down for the third quarter in a row.
But Mr. Pulitzer, every paper circulation is down since the war ended.
Whoever said war is hell wasn't trying to sell newspapers.
We could use an exciting headline.
Well, what have we got today?
The trolley strike?
That's not exciting. It's epic.
It's boring. Folks want to know, is the trolley coming or ain't it? No one cares why.
And the strike's about to be settled. Governor Roosevelt just put his support behind the workers.
That man is a socialist!
Teddy Roosevelt's a socialist? He's an American hero!
The man won't sound off football for being too violent. Football. Violent. You're right. He's no socialist. He's a commie.
Mr. Pulitzer, please try to sit still.
Gentlemen, please. You're making Nunzio nervous. And when Nunzio gets nervous, I don't, look pretty.
You never liked Roosevelt. When he ran for governor, you wrote an editorial against him day after day. And guess what? He still got elected.
How am I supposed to influence voters if they are not reading my opinion?
Big photos attract readers.
Do you know what big photos cost?
But without big photos or flashy headlines, how are we supposed to sell more papers?
Gentlemen, there is an answer right before your eyes. You're just not thinking this through. People, Nunzio knows when he's cutting my hair. Trim a bit here, and then trim a bit there. Just a modest adjustment can fatten the bottom line. Shaving is tricky, the razor should float. Shave me too close, and you may slit my throat. It's the simplest solutions that bolster the bottom line.
We don't sell paper, silly. Newsies do.
Exactly, silly. Newsies sell papers.
I've got it. Right now, we charge the newsies 50 cents for 100 papers.
Yes.
But if we raise that price to 60 cents per 100...
Now you are getting somewhere.
A mere tenth of a penny per paper.
Every single newsie would have to sell 10 more papers just to earn the same amount as always.
My thought exactly. It's genius.
It's going to be awfully rough on those children.
Nonsense. I'll be offering them a real-life lesson in economics.
I could offer them a better education if they have my own.
Give me a week and I'll train them to be like an army that's marching to war. Proud of themselves and so grateful to me, they'll be begging to pay them. Relax! Why throw them out? All you need is some wax. Listen well to these barbershop lessons. They'll see you through.
There's nothing the moon can be fine. All the race any trains will be fine.
With a trim
and a slip
and a shine.
Yes! Once again is mine! The price for the newsies goes up.
Watching the
paper! Evening paper, yeah?
You're singing under sleep. Here. Extra, extra, terrified flight from burning inferno. You heard the story right here. Thanks, mister.
You just made that up.
I did not. I said he heard it right here and he did.
Yeah, well, my father taught us not to lie.
Yeah, well, Mike taught me not to starve.
That's one last paper.
I got one more.
Sell it or pay for it. To the breed!
This is so much better than school!
Don't even think it. When Pop goes back to work, we go back to school.
Alright, so how about we divvy up the money, find you somewhere safe to spend the night?
Oh, we gotta get home. Our folks will be waiting for dinner.
Oh, you got folks, huh?
Doesn't everyone?
Our dad tangled with a delivery truck on the job. He messed up his leg bad, so they laid him off. Oh, that's how come we have to find Mark.
Yeah, sure. That makes sense. Sorry about your dad.
Why don't you come home with us for dinner? Our folks would be happy to have you.
Mom's a great cook.
Oh, I just remembered. I'm meeting a fella. He's probably waiting on me right now. So,
is that the guy you're meeting?
Kelly, run for it!
I think we lost them.
Someone want to tell me why I'm running? I got no one chasing me. Who was that guy?
That there was Snyder the Spider. A real sweetie. He runs a jail for underage kids called the Refuge. City pays him for every kid he locks up. Problem is, all the money goes into his own pocket. So do yourself a favor and steer clear of him and the Refuge. Oh, not even me, Miss Nina.
Jack, man, oh, mister, come here and give me a hug. Where have you been keeping yourself, kid?
Oh, never far from you, Miss Meta. Boys, may I present Miss Meta Larkin, the greatest star on the Bowery today. She also owns the joint.
The only thing I own is the mortgage. A pleasure.
A pleasure. What's wrong with you? That's her costume!
I can see the legs!
Step out of his way so he can get a better look. Theater's not only entertaining, it's educational. Got the picture, kid?
Miss Meta, we got into a little situation out on the street. Can we hide out here for a while?
Where better to escape trouble than the theater? Is Snyder after you again?
Hey, Jack. Can you escape jail in the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage?
What would the governor be doing at a juvenile jail?
Well, it just so happens he was running for office. I'm not sure he cared about orphans and such, so... Well, he got his mug in the paper. He got my butt in the back seat, and we rode off together.
You really know the governor?
He don't, but I do. Say, Jack, when you've got time, I want you to paint me another one of these backdrops. The last one you did is a doozy. Folks love it, and... things have been going so well that I can actually pay.
I could never take your money, Miss Meta.
You picture that?
Your friend is quite an artist.
Okay, don't get carried away. It's a bunch of trees.
No, you're really good.
The boy's got natural aptitude.
Jeez, I never even know what
was. Miss Meta, you're on.
Yeah? How am I doing? Boys, lock the doors and stay all night. You're with Meta now.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the star of our show, Miss Meta Larkin!
I'm doing alright for myself, folks. I'm healthy, I'm wealthy, I'm wise.
I've got men, I've got money, and yet the thing I want most I can't get. Well, hello! Welcome to my theater. I live in a mansion on Long Island Sound. I pulled up the wing, they found oil in the ground. But you're telling me you don't want me around. Now, honey, that's rich. Some guys give me a ranch and chiller and mink. And some give me diamonds as big as a sink. But you wouldn't give me so much as a wink. Now, baby, that's rich. I get brandy from Andy and candy from Scott. And Frank and Eduardo choked in for a yacht. I get stares from the fellas and prayers from the Pope. But I ran out my luck getting stuck on some dope. Oh, hey, baby, I was just talking about you. Now listen, sport, this life's too short to waste it on you. It may be rough, but soon enough
you.
Ten fire sirens kept me awake all night.
Sirens is like lullabies to me. The louder they wail, the better the headline. And the better the headline, the better I eat. And the better I eat,
the further away from you I sleep. Hey, godmother, I was gonna get me one.
What'd you do with the one you had?
We traded her for a box of cigars.
Hey, they was Coronas.
Ooh, a mother and a father.
Well, ain't we the hoi polloi?
So, how's it going today?
Ask me after they put the headline.
Well, there it is now.
New newsy price. 60 cents per hundred?
What'd you say? Is that news?
It is to me.
They jacked up the price of the papes. 10 cents more a hundred.
I can eat 2 days on a dime.
I'll be sleeping on the street.
You already sleep on the street.
In a worse neighborhood.
You're right.
Hey, why is everyone standing around?
Get a load of this, Jay.
Thanks for the newsies.
Hey, relax. It's gotta be a gag.
Light up, boys.
Hey, good joke, Weasel. Yeah, you really got me and the fellas going. Yeah, I'll take 100 and be on my way.
100 will cost you 60.
What?
I ain't paying no 60.
Then make way for someone who will.
You bet. Me and the fellas will take our business to the sun.
Yes! Yeah. Yeah. Walk. They have that for us too.
Hey, then we'll go to the jungle.
Yeah!
It's the same all around town. New day, new price.
Why the jackup?
For them kind of answers? You gotta ask a little further up the food chain. So, you buying? Moving on.
Come here, fellas. I said come here.
They can't just do that, can they?
Why not? It's their paper.
It's their world.
We got the right.
We got the right to stop. Come on, fellas. Let's grab our papers and hit the streets while we still can.
Damn prices.
We got a choice.
Hey, nobody's paying no nothing.
You got an idea?
Hey, keep your shirt on. Let me think you through.
What's your angle?
Let the mayor work it out.
Oh, hey,
okay.
Yeah, still thinking?
Sure is. Can't you smell smoke?
Okay, here's the deal. Come here. If we don't sell pipes, then no one sells pipes. Nobody gets to that window until they put the price back down where it belongs.
You mean like a strike?
Hey, you heard the man. We're on strike!
Yeah! Yeah.
So we'll shut this place down like the workers shut down the trolley.
The cops will bust our heads. Captain Strike is slated with broke bones.
And no cops is gonna care about a bunch of kids. Right, Davey?
Leave me out of this. Just trying to feed my family.
And the rest of us is here on playtime? Hey, just because we only make pennies? Don't give nobody the right to rub our noses in it.
It doesn't matter. You can't strike. You're not a union.
What if I says we is?
There's a lot of stuff you gotta have in order to be a union. Like membership.
What do you call these guys?
Hey.
And officers?
I nominate Jack President!
Gee, I'm touched.
How about a statement of purpose?
Must have left it in my other pants.
What's the statement?
A reason for forming the union.
Well, what reason did the trolley workers have?
I don't know. Wages, work hours, safety on the job.
And who don't need those? I bet if your father had a union, you wouldn't have to be out here selling pipes, yeah?
Yeah.
So our union is hereby formed to watch each other's backs.
Yeah.
Union we stand. Hey, that's not bad. Somebody should write that down.
Yeah.
Got a pencil.
We'll meet our Secretary of State!
Hey!
If I'm on a strike, the membership's gotta vote.
Okay.
That's right.
So let's vote. Fellas, do we roll over and the poor will pick our pockets? Or do we strike?
Strike!
You heard the voice of the membership. The Newsies of Lawmen had no officially on strike. So what's next?
Oh, will the strike be more effective if someone in charge knew about
it? Well, it would be a pleasure to tell Weasel myself.
Yeah, and who tells Pulitzer? Davey?
I don't know. I guess.
You do, Mr. President. That's right.
Yeah.
We do. So, what do we tell him?
the newspaper owners respect our rights as employees.
Yeah, and Pulitzer and Earth gotta respect the worker rights of the kids in this city.
Yeah. Yeah. They can't just change the rules when they feel like it.
Yeah, yeah, we do the work so we get a say.
Yeah. We got a union.
Yeah. They think we're nothing! Are we nothing?
No! They need to understand that we're not enslaved to them! We are free agents!
Pulitzer and Hearst, they think they got us! They got us!
No! We're a union now! The Newsboys Union, and we mean business!
Even though we ain't got hats or badges, we're a union just by saying so! And the world will know!
What's to stop some of the kids to come along and sell our papes? Alright, we cannot beat up on other kids. We are all in this together.
What's it gonna take to stop the wagons? Are we ready?
Yeah!
What's it gonna take to stop the scabbers? Can we do it?
Yeah!
Wonder what we gotta do until we break the will of mighty Bill and Joe. And the world will know that the sky don't turn. Hearst and Pulitzer, have we got news for you? See, the world don't know what they're gonna pay. Instead of honking headlights, we'll be making on today. And our race will grow,
and we'll kick their ears.
Yeah! And the world will know that we've been here. When the circulation bell starts ringing, will we hear it?
No!
What if the Delanceys come out swinging? Will we hear it?
No!
When you got 100 voices singing, who can hear a lousy whistle blow? And the world will know that this ain't no game. That we got a ton of money through them perfect day. So they gave their word. Gonna see what stop the presses really means. And the old will weep, they go back to sleep. And we got no choice but to see it grow.
And we don't know who is our first ones.
And the world will.
And the things we do today will be tomorrow's news.
And the die is cast, and the torch is passed, and the world will rise, and the race will grow and grow, and so the world will feel the burn and finally know.
Us out. Take away our boat!
When we let them stop this crappy garbage down our throat. Every day we wait is a day we lose. And this ain't for fun, and it ain't for show. And we'll fight up toes and toe and show. The world will feel the
Yeah.
And ah! Who's the big spender? What would it sell?
Over here!
And that'll cost you 2 cents.
2 cents for a glass of seltzer? Just give me a water.
How did I ever see that coming?
I'd say we launched our strike in the most auspicious manner.
I don't know about that, but we sure scared the bejeebus out of weasels.
Yeah, we did.
The last season didn't know which way was up.
Oh.
All right, so what's next?
Now we have to spread the word. Let the rest of the city's newsies know about the strike.
Well, you heard the man. Spread the word.
I'll take Harlem.
I got Midtown.
I got the Bronx. I got the Bowery.
Tommy Boy, East Side. Specs, Queens.
Yep.
And who wants Brooklyn? Brooklyn, the spot columns place, the big fellas, big boys. No? Finch! You're telling me you're scared of Brooklyn.
Hey, I ain't scared of no turf! It's just that spot column that gets me a little jittery.
Yeah. All right, me and Davey will take Brooklyn.
Me? I have
to. Why is everybody so scared of Brooklyn?
What are you doing here?
Asking a question. Have you got an answer?
Yeah. Brooklyn's the sixth largest city in the entire world. Yeah, Brooklyn. Hit the mother world. Hey, for someone who works at the Sun, you spend an awful lot of time hanging around the world. What's up with that? Are you following me?
The only thing I'm following is a story. A ragtag gang of ragamuffins wants to take on the Kingmakers of New York. Do you think you have a chance?
Shouldn't you be at the ballet?
Questions are difficult. I'll rephrase. Will the richest and most powerful men in the city give the time of day to a gang of kids who haven't got a nickel to their name?
Hey, you don't gotta be insulted.
I got a nickel.
So I guess you'd say you're a couple of Davids looking to take on Goliath?
We never said that.
You didn't have to. I did. This is entertaining so far.
Well, I noticed a lot of news in my day, and I never known a no-girl reporter writing hard news.
Wake up to the new century. The game's changing. How about an exclusive interview?
What's the last news story you wrote?
What's the last strike you organized?
Oh!
Step aside, Kelly. Me thinks the lady needs a real man.
You think's wrong, Romeo.
How'd she know my name?
I say we save any exclusive for a real reporter.
Do you see anybody else giving you the time of day? Alright, so I'm just busting out of the social pages, but I promise, if you give me the story and let me run with it, I'll get you the space.
You really think we could be in the papers?
Shut down a paper like the world, and you're going to make the front page.
Alright, you want a story, you'll get one. Be at the circulation gate tomorrow at 10 a.m. Oh, and bring a camera. You're gonna want to snap a picture of this!
All right, boys. Go play outside. I gotta clean up for dinner. I got paying customers who need to pay.
Come on, we got Newsies to visit.
Yeah, you won't be shooting us off when we get our bug in the papes.
We'll be keeping score. Either they gives us our rights or we gives them a whore.
Are you kidding me?
But you're an artist. You've got real talent. You should be inside the paper illustrating, not outside hawking it.
Maybe it ain't what I want.
So tell me what you want.
Can't you see it in my eyes?
Have you always been their leader?
I'm a blowhard. Davey's the brains.
Modesty is not a quality I would have pinned on you.
You got a name?
Catherine Plummer.
What's the matter, ain't you sure?
It's my byline, the name I publish under. Tell me about tomorrow. What are you hoping for?
I'd rather tell you what I'm hoping for tonight.
Mr. Kelly.
Today the newsies didn't deliver papers to the city, but the wagon's still delivered to the rest of it. Tomorrow, we stop the wagons.
Are you scared?
Hey, now do I look scared? But ask me again in the morning.
Good answer. Good night, Mr. Kelly.
Hey, where are you going? It ain't even supper time.
I'll see you in the morning. And off the record, good luck.
Hey, plumber. Write it good. We both got a lot riding on you.
You heard the man. Write it good. Write it good or it's back to wheezing your way through the flower show. No pressure. Let's go. Newsies stop the world. A little hyperbole never hurt anyone. With all eyes fixed on the trolley strike, there's another battle brewing in the city. And if I could just write about it. Come on, Catherine, those boys are counting on you. Oh, you poor boys. Write what you know, so they say. All I know is I don't know what to write or the right way to write it. This is big, lady, don't screw it up. This is not some little bud. Will I review me with poor little kids? Horses, rich, greedy, sour pusses. Oh, it's a snitch. It can practically write itself. And let's pray it does, because as I may have mentioned, I have no clue what I review me. Am I insane? This is what I've been waiting for. Well, that was the screaming of dead angry editors. A girl? It's a girl. How the hell? Is that even legal?
Century.
Is anyone else coming?
I don't got a clue.
Have you seen Spock on the right? What'd he say?
Yeah, sure, we've seen him.
Yeah, him and about 20 of his gang.
And I gotta say, Spock was very impressed, wasn't he?
I'd say.
So they're with us.
That all depends on how you look at it. If you look and see Brooklyn, then they're with us.
They wanted proof we're not gonna fold at the first sign of trouble.
Are we?
We are not! There's us in Harlem!
Not so fast, boss. Harlem wants to know what Brooklyn's gonna do.
Specs, what about Queens?
Queens will be right here back.
Yeah, you're right!
As soon as we get the nod from Brooklyn.
Say, Oscar, looks like you got some bum information about a strike going on here today. Not that I'm complaining. My skull busts and arms a day to rest.
Jack, are you doing the right thing?
Hey, sure we are.
Say, Jack, maybe we don't put this off a couple of days.
No, we can't! Jack, tell them, if we back off now, then it will never listen to us again.
I know. Hey. The fellas like it or not, no matter who does or who doesn't show. Now is when we take our stand.
How about we just don't show for work? That'll send a message.
No, they'll just replace us. They need to see us stand our ground. Davey, tell them. Things were gutter rats! With no respect for nothing.
including each other. Is that who we are? We stab each other in the back, and yeah, that's who we are. Hey, but if we stand together, we change the whole game. And it ain't just about us. There are boys and girls all across the city who want to be playing or going to school, but it's that they are slaving away to support themselves and their folks. And it ain't no crime being poor. Not one of us complains about the hard work we do. All we ask is a square deal. So fellas, I beg of you, for the sake of every kid in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse in this city, throw down your pipes. Join the strike.
Please.
I'm with ya.
Now's the time to seize the day.
Now's the time to seize the day.
Answer the call and don't delay.
Answer the call and don't delay. Wrongs will be righted. If we're united, let us seize the day.
Oh, what the hell? My father's gonna kill me anyway!
Yeah! House into Harlem, look what's begun. Run for all and all for us. Strike!
Thank you.
think it's time these kids learned their lesson, huh?
Nosies! Get them!
Yeah.
say I don't give you nothing. Before you say water is nothing, just ask a fish. In the desert!
Why do old people talk?
To prove they still alive.
Good morning, gentlemen! Would you get a load of these Guam mugs? Could these really be the same boys who made front page of the New York Sun?
Oh, she just say what? Let me see. Would you look at that's me?
Hey, from page, you're not even dead.
Wait a minute.
Where's me? Where's me?
Wait till old man gets a load of this. I won't be less alive for the talk tonight.
You really got us in the papers?
You got yourselves in the papers.
Let me see.
Stop
the world. Now that's
a headline
you would ever
put.
So what else you got?
Mine's the only story that ran. Pulitzer declared a blackout on strike news, so even I'm shut down now. Hey, I heard they arrested Crutchy. Did they get Jack too?
The Delancey just spread the story that he hit the lamp first side of the cop.
Jack, I'm not for
hey, keep it down, show stuff. I'm just reporting the news.
For Jumpin' Jack's sake, can you stow the curiosity long enough to just drink in the moment I'm famous? What of it? Well, are you stupid or what? When you're famous, the world is your oyster.
Yo, what?
What?
What is it? What are you saying?
Your oyster.
I don't know what that is.
Your oyster.
What?
You know your fancy clam with the pollo inside.
That's an oyster.
What?
And how much does being famous pay?
No, you don't need money when you're famous. They give you whatever you want, gratis.
The jazz.
A pair of new shoes with the matching laces.
A perfect box and the shoes and Reese's.
From the on by with this apple of people.
A son of a woman and go.
Look at me, I'm the king of New York.
Yeah, I said.
Certainly, I'm respectable. Stand right at you, lousy with stature.
My name is Dr. Marketing, my son blowing my dough and going deluxe.
And there I be. It's my city, I'm the king of New York.
So let's get drunk!
and see. This is gonna make both of the Wensies be in their pansies. Lunchbox and shoot and bright as the sun. I'm a highfalutin son of a gun. I guarantee, oh, I cracked out, I ain't tapped out. I'm the king of friends may flee, but on the chest, snap one pitcher, you're the king of new. Unpaid story, guts and glory, I'm the king.
Guess I wasn't much hope yesterday. Snyder soaked me real good with my crutch. Oh yeah, Jack, this is crutchy, by the way. These here guards, they is rude. They say jump, boy you jump or you're screwed. But the food ain't so badly so far, 'cause so far they ain't brung us no food. Ha, ha. I miss the rooftop. Sleeping right out in the open in your penthouse in the sky. There's a cool breeze blowing even in July. Anyway, so guess what? There's a secret escape plan I got. Tie a sheet to the bed, toss the end out the window, climb down and take off like a shot. Maybe though, not tonight. I ain't slept and my legs still ain't right. Hey, but Pulitzer, he's going down. And then Jack, I was thinking we might just go like you were saying. Where it's with no buildings in your way, and you ride in palominos every day. Once that train makes, damn this place, I'll be fine, good as new. But there's one thing I need you to do. On the rooftop, you said that a family looks out for each other. So you tell all the fellas for me to protect one another. The end. Your friend. Your best friend. Your brother, Crutchy.
Thank you.
first backdrop, plus this one, and just a little something I count on because I'm gonna miss you so.
Miss Meta.
Jack.
Yeah, Jim.
Just tell me you're going somewhere, not running away.
Does it matter?
When you go somewhere, and it turns out not to be the right place, you can always go somewhere else. But when you're running away, nowhere's ever the right place.
How about letting a pal know you're alive?
Why don't I leave you with your friend?
Jack, where'd you go? We couldn't find you.
I think I didn't want to be found.
Is that a real place? That Santa Fe? Hey, you've seen the papes. We're front page news. Above the fold. Oh yes, above the fold.
Good for you.
Everyone wants to meet the famous Jack Kelly. Even Spot Collins had a kid just to say, next event, you can count on Brooklyn. How about that?
Dave, we got stomped to the ground.
They got us this time, I'll grant you that. But we took round one. And with press like this, our fight is far from over.
Every nosy who could walk show up to work like the strike didn't even happen.
And I was right there with them. If I don't sell papes, my folks don't eat.
Save your breath. No, I get it, it's hopeless.
But then I saw this look on Weasel's face. He was actually nervous, and I realized that this is far from over. We got them worried. Really worried, and I walked away, lots of other kids did too. And that's what you call a beginning.
There he is, just like I said.
What's a fella gotta do to get away from you people?
There's no escape in his power, inevitable.
So what's the story, can we have a fear?
Pipe down, I didn't ask yet.
What's a hold up? I need to let my girl know, we've got a date.
You're a girl?
You heard me. I've been swatting skirts away all morning. The name is what? Intoxicating potion. This here girl, Sally? She's a plum.
What is you wrote a good story?
You look terrible.
Hey, Jack, where's that supposed to be?
That's Santa Fe.
I've got to tell you, Jack, this Go West Young Man routine is getting tired. Even Horace Greeley moved back to New York.
Yes, he did. Then he died.
A reporter supposed to be nonpartisan or something?
Ask a reporter. Pulitzer's had me blacklisted from every news desk in town.
Can we table the plot and get back to business? We'll meet outside the theater.
It's what I've been trying to tell you. We want to hold a rally, a citywide meeting where every newsie gets a say and a vote. And we do it after working hours so no one loses a day's pay. Smart?
Smart enough to get you committed to a padded room.
The guy who paints places he's never seen is calling us crazy.
Oh, you want to see a place I've seen? Is that it, huh? Nosy square! Thanks to my big mouth! Overflowing with failure! Some kids hurt, others arrested!
Why not? No one died!
Is that what you're going for? Go on, call me a quitter, call me a coward. There's no way! I am putting them kids back in danger.
We're doing something that has never been done before. How can that not be dangerous?
Specs brought me a note from the refuge. I tried to go see him, you know. But they busted him up so bad, he couldn't even walk to the window. What if he don't make it? Are you on the short of that? For a tenth of a penny of paper.
Jack, it's not about the pennies. You said it yourself, my family wouldn't be in the mess we were in if my father had a union. This is a fight we have to win.
If I wanted a sermon, I'd show up for church.
Tell me how quitting does Crutchy any good. Exactly. So here's how it goes once we win, and we will be winning, make no mistake.
We'll be what?
We're already winning.
Right.
And we'll tell them straight out, they let Crutchy go, and they keep getting pounded.
Dave, what the hell did they bust a few brains or something? As I recall, Dave, we all got our asses kicked, they won.
Won the battle.
Oh, come on!
Just think about it, we've got them.
surrounded.
Here's what I think, Joe's a judge, he's a rattlesnake.
You're right, and you know why a snake starts to rattle.
No, why?
Cause he's scared.
Sure.
Go on, look it up, the poor guy's head is spinning. Why would he send for the goons? An entire army, dozens of goons, plus the cops.
So you know you may be right.
Thank you, God.
He wasn't afraid.
Exactly. He knows we're winning.
I've read your editorials, Mr. Pulitzer. How can you express so much sympathy for the trolley workers, but yet have none for the Newsies?
The trolley workers are striking for a fair contract. The Newsies are striking against me.
I'd spare you this embarrassment if I could, but the Burles house is private property.
He can't order a raid without legal cause.
Mr. Mayor, would the fact that this rally is organized by an escaped convict be enough to shut it down?
An escaped convict?
A fugitive from one of your own institutions. A convicted thief at large wreaking havoc on our law-abiding community. Mr. Snyder, which one is he?
That one there.
And how do you know this boy?
He was first sentenced to my refuge for loitering and vagrancy, but his total disregard for authority has made me a frequent visitor.
You called him a thief and an escaped convict.
After his release, I caught him myself red-handed, trafficking stolen food and clothing. But alas, the willful ruffian escaped.
So, you'd be doing the city a service by removing this criminal from our streets.
Well, I guess if that's the case, we can take him in quietly and then—
What good does quietly do me? I want a public example made out of him.
Mr. Pulitzer, the boy Jack Kelly is here.
Here?
He's asked to speak to you. He's just outside.
Ask and he shall be received. Mr. Mayor? Mr. Snyder, if you please. Catherine, sit.
Mr. Jack Kelly.
Afternoon, Joe. How we doing?
And which Jack Kelly is this? The charismatic union organizer, or the escaped convict and convicted thief?
Which one gives us more in common?
Impudence is in bad taste when crawling for mercy.
You're crawling? Now that's a laugh. No, I just stopped by with an invite. It seems a few hundred of your disgruntled employees are rallying to discuss recent disagreements. I thought since you're the boss and such, it's only fair to invite you. So what do you say, John? Should I save you a spot on the bill?
You are as shameless and disrespectful of a creature as I was told. Do you know what I was doing when I was your age, boy? I was fighting in a war.
Yeah, and how did that turn out for you?
Taught me a lesson that shaped my life. You don't win a war on the battlefield. It's the headline that crowns the victor.
Yeah, well, you can tell that to New York City. When they wake up to the front page being our rally.
Rally till the cows come home. Not a paper in town will publish a word. And if it wasn't in the papers, it never happened.
You may run this city, but there are some of us who can't be bullied. Even some reporters.
Such as that young woman who made you yesterday's news. Talented girl, and beautiful too. Wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I'll tell her you said so.
Oh, no need. She can hear for herself. Can't you, darling? I trust you know my daughter, Catherine. Yes, that's right, my daughter. Now you might be asking why the nom de plume and why doesn't my daughter work for me? Good questions. I offered Catherine a life of wealth and leisure, and instead she chose to pursue a career. And she was showing real promise until this recent lapse. But you're all done with that now, aren't you, darling?
Jack, I didn't mean—
Don't trouble the boy with your problems, dearest. Mr. Kelly has a plateful of his own. What did you say so, Mr. Snyder?
Hello, Jack.
Ooh, does anybody else feel a noose tightening? But allow me to offer an alternate scenario. You attend this rally and speak against this hopeless strike, and I will see your criminal record expunged and your pockets filled with enough cash to carry you on a first-class train compartment from New York to New Mexico and beyond. You did say he wanted to travel west, didn't you, darling?
There ain't a person in this room. They don't know you stink!
And if they know me, they know I don't care. Mark my words, boy. Defy me, and I will have every single one of you and your friends locked up in the refuge. And it's not right to condemn that poor little crippled boy to conditions like that. And what about your pal Davy and his baby brother? Ripped from their loving families and tossed to the rats. How will they ever be able to thank you enough? Time's running out, kid. So what do you say? Cowboy or convict? I win. Either way, your abject surrender was always the bottom line. Gentlemen, escort our guest to the cellar so he may reflect in solitude. Too bad you know job, Jack, but you did resign. Too bad you know family, but you can't have mine. Be glad you're alive, boy, I'd say that's the bottom line. Like the Pied Piper, you knew what to play, so those kids all believed you were right. Lucky for them, all but one got away. They may not be so lucky tonight.
We've been given discretion to handle you as we see fit, so behave! But, just in case, I've been polishing my favorite brass knuckles. You can sleep here for tonight, beside this old printing press. Ain't that right, Oscar?
Yeah.
Pay us a visit and see what we need. And when you do, we'll kick you halfway
to the breeze. Now that soldiers is in for a stomach, what a sad way to end a career. There's a joke.
What a day since we're choking, loud and clear. Manhattan is here, Ocean's here, Richmond's here, Woodside's here, Brooklyn's here.
Yeah, that's right.
Let's hear it for Spot Colin in Brooklyn.
Oh, Spot.
Newsies United. Let's just see what Putz has to say to us now.
Yeah. Hey, Davey, where's Jack?
I haven't seen him.
No sign of him yet. Looks like you're doing a solo.
Jack.
Newsies of New York. Look at what we've done. We've got newsies from every neighborhood and every city here tonight. Tonight, we are making history!
Yeah, we are!
Tonight, we declare that we are just as much a part of the newspaper as any news reporter or editor.
Yeah, that's right.
We are done being treated like kids.
Yeah.
From now on, they will treat us as equals.
Yeah, they will.
You want to be treated like an adult and start acting like one.
And here's Jack.
Jack.
All right.
Jack.
Porter raised the price of the papes without so much as a word to us. That was a lousy thing to do. So we let him know we ain't gonna be pushed around. So then what happens? Porter lowers the price of the papes so we's go back to work. Yeah. And after that, he just raises it again. And he will again after that, and don't think he won't. Fellas, we gotta be realistic. How many days do you think you could go without making money? Because believe me, Porter can go longer. I met with Mr. Porter. He's given me his word that if we disband the union, that he will raise the price again for 2 years. I say we take the deal. Go back to work knowing that our price is secure. All we have to do is vote no on the strike. They vote no!
Some speech you made.
How'd you get here?
Spec showed me.
He said he could go through my stuff too?
I saw them rolled up sticking out of there and I didn't know what they were. Those drawings, they're drawings of the refuge, aren't they? Is that really what it's like in there? Three boys to a bed and rats everywhere?
A little different from where you were raised.
Snyder told my father that you were arrested for stealing food and clothing. This is why, isn't it? You stole to feed those boys. I don't understand. If you were willing to go to jail for them, how could you turn your back on them now?
Well, you are no one to talk about turning back on folks.
I never turned on you or anyone else.
No, you just double-crossed us. To your father! Your father!
My father has eyes on every corner of this city. He doesn't need me spying for him. And I never lied. I just didn't tell you everything.
If you want to go, you'd be talking with the fist in your mouth.
I said that I work for the Sun, and I do. And I said that my professional name is Plumber, and it is. You never asked my real one.
Well, I wouldn't think I had to unless I was dealing with the backstabber.
If I were a boy, you'd be looking at me through one swollen eye.
Oh, don't let it stop you. Give it your best shot.
Oh,
the money.
No, of course not. You heard your father, no matter how many days we strike. She ain't giving in. I just don't know what else we can do.
But I do.
Oh, come on.
Really, Jack? Really? Only you can have a good idea? Or is it because I'm a girl?
I never said nothing.
Now would be a good time to shut up. Being boss doesn't mean you have all the answers, just the brains to recognize a right one when you hear it.
I'm listening.
Good for you. The strike was your idea, the rally was Davies, and now my plan will take us to the finish line. Deal with it.
The children's crusade?
For the sake of all the kids in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse in New York, I beg you, join us. With those words, the strike stopped being just about the Newsies. You challenged our whole generation to stand up and demand a place at the table.
The children's crusade.
Think, Jack, if we published this, my words, with one of your drawings, and if every kid under 21 read it and stayed home from work, or better yet, came to Newsies Square, a general citywide strike.
There's just one problem. There's no way to print it.
There has to be at least one printing press he doesn't control.
Oh, no.
What?
I know a place that no one would ever think we'd use.
Well, then why are we still standing here? Let's
go. Wait. What's this about for you? I don't mean the children's crusade. I mean, what's this about for you? Am I kidding myself, or is there something here?
Of course there is.
Well, don't just say it like it happens
well,
every
that's
day.
That's all I meant,
but... Now, look, I ain't stupid. I know guys like me don't end up with girls like you. But standing here tonight, I just wish I could grab hold of something to make time stop. Just so I can keep looking at you.
You snuck up on me, Jack Kelly. I never even saw it coming.
For sure?
For sure. Now I'm learning what is true, that love will do what it does. The world finds ways to sting you, and then one day decides to bring you something to believe in for even a night maybe forever, but that's all right. That's
someone sweet passing by. And if your father wasn't after my head.
You're not really scared.
father.
No. I am pretty scared of you.
Don't be.
Was covered, Dave.
We could hold a hoedown in here and no one would be the wiser.
Hey, good job.
Hey, it's good to have you back again.
You shut up.
Here she is, boys. Just think, while my father snores blissfully in his bed, we'll be using his very own printing press to bring him down.
Remind me to stay on your good side.
So, is this what they print the papers on?
I can see why they tossed this old girl down to the cellar, but I think she'll do the job.
Jack, this is Darcy. He knows just about everything there is to know about printing.
He works for one of the papes.
My father owns the trip.
Wow.
Oh, and this is Bill. He'll be typesetting the article for us.
Yeah, I suppose he works for... No, he's the son of William Randolph First.
And proud to be a part of your revolution.
Ain't that something?
In the words of the little one, can we table the palaver and get down to business?
All right, here's how it'll work. As we print the papers, Race, you let the fellas in, and we'll spread them to every working kid in New York. After that?
After that, it's up to them.
There's change coming once and for all. You make the front page, and man, you is made.
This is the story we needed to write, best be kept out of sight for no more. In a few hours, by dawn's early light, we'll be ready to fight a civil war. This time we're in it to stay, talk about seizing the day.
Damn well paid.
Steel and bullets are snug in his bed. He don't care if we're dead or alive. Three satin pillows are under his head while he's begging for bread to survive. So you can stop counting sheep. We're gonna sing, get asleep. Then while you snooze, we'll be light and abused with a promise he's aching to keep.
For all, if they don't mind, the man is well bleed on.
Bleed on.
Once and for all, we won't carry no banners that don't spell freedom.
Finally, he's raising the stakes. This time, whatever it takes. This time, the Union awakes. Once and for all.
In the words of Union leader Jack Kelly, we will work with you. We will even work for you. But we will be paid and treated as valuable members of your organization. Riveting stuff, huh?
We've got a very important meeting to see.
Keep your fingers crossed.
For us too.
This is for kids shining shoes on the street with those shoes on their feet every day.
This is for guys sweating blood in the shops while their bosses and cops look away. I'm seeing kids getting tall, glaring rare in the brawl. Armies of guys who are sick of the lies, getting ready to rise to the call. Worship for all of your blood on the wall that they doubt us. They think they're running this town, but this town will shut down without us. 10,000 kids in the square, 10,000 fists in the air.
Sorry, but he'll have to call you back.
Mr. Potter can't speak right now. He'll call you back.
I'm sorry.
Silence those phones!
The entire city is shut down. No one's working anywhere, and everyone's blaming you.
They're all calling the publishers, the manufacturers, the mayor, and such language.
Afternoon, boys. How we doing?
You can't just barge in here.
You're behind this. I thought we had a deal.
Oh, we did. But it came with money back guarantee. Thanks for your lesson on the powers of the press and such.
Did you read this, boss? These kids have put out a pretty good paper. Very convincing.
No doubt written by my daughter.
Yeah, I'd snatch up before somebody else does.
I demand to know who defied my ban on printing strike material.
We are your loyal employees. We will never take our business elsewhere.
The old printing press and the cellar. I made you the opportunity of a lifetime. Anyone who doesn't act in their own self-interest is a fool.
What's that make you? This all began because you wanted to sell more papers, but now your circulation is down 70%. Why didn't you just come talk to us?
Because guys like Joe don't talk with nothings like us. You know, but a wise reporter once told me, a good boss don't have to have all the answers. Just as smart to snatch the right one up when he hears it.
Your daughter's here and you won't believe who else.
I think you know the governor.
Governor Roosevelt.
Joseph, Joseph, what have you done now?
I'm certain when you hear my explanation...
Thanks to Miss Meta Larkin for bringing your daughter to my office. I already have a thorough grasp of this situation, graphic illustrations included. Now, bully is the term I would usually employ to show approval, but in your case I simply mean bully. And is this the boy of whom you spoke? How are you, son? I'm told we once shared a carriage ride together.
The pleasure's mine, Governor.
Well, Joseph,
Don't just sit there letting those children sing endlessly. Tell them the good news.
What good news?
That you've had a change of heart, and you're going to put the prices back down where they should be. Unless, of course, you would like to invite a full state senate investigation of your employment practices.
You wouldn't dare!
After the pressure you put on me to keep me out of office, I'd do it with a smile. Oh, come now, Joseph. The only thing worse than a hard heart is a soft head. And think of all the happiness you would bring to those children. He doesn't do happiness, does he?
Mr. Kelly, if I may speak to you alone.
Keep your eyes to the stars and your feet on the ground. You can do this.
I cannot put the price of the paper back where it was. I'm sorry, there are other considerations.
I get it. You gotta face front all these people.
Thank you for understanding.
Hey, but I got constituents with a legitimate gripe.
What if I reduce the raise by half and get the others to do the same? It's a compromise we can all live with.
But you eat our losses. For every pipe we don't sell, you buy back full price.
That was never on the table. What's to stop Newsies from taking hundreds of papers they can't sell? My costs will explode.
No Newsies gonna haul around papers he can't sell. But if he could buy a few more, with no risk, and he actually sells them, the circulation would begin to grow. It's a compromise we can both live with.
That's not a bad head you've got on your shoulders.
Deal?
That's disgusting.
It's the price of doing business.
Each generation must, at the height of its power, invite the youngin' to share the day. You all have laid great claim to our civilization, and I believe that in the future, in your hands, it shall be bright and prosperous. In your drawing, son, I brought an entirely different matter to bear. Officers, if you please!
Hey, watch it, Jack! It's crunchy!
Look at what I brought you to give straight from the refuge. Bring him in, fellas.
It's Snyder the Spider.
He don't look so tough no more, does he?
With your drawings, Jack, you made an eloquent argument for the shutting down of the refuge. Be assured that Mr. Snyder's abuses will be investigated fully. Officer, take him away.
Please, Your Highness, may I do the honors?
As you wish.
How humiliating.
And you'll be laughing all the way to the pin, little man. So long, sucker!
Oh, bye-bye.
Thank you, Governor.
I can't help but thinking. If one of your drawings convinced the Governor to shut down the refuge, what might a daily political cartoon do to expose dealings in our government's back rooms? What do you say, Teddy? Care to have this young man's artistry shine a lantern behind your closed doors?
Hey, don't sweat it, Governor. The strike's settled. I should probably be hitting the road.
Why? I don't get it. What's Santa Fe got that New York ain't?
Or better yet, what's New York got that Santa Fe ain't?
New York's got us. And we're family.
Hey, didn't I hear something about a strike being settled?
Phipps,
Phipps ain't gonna sell themselves.
Come on, Governor, and show me the back seat that I've learned so much about. Well, don't just stand there. We've got a union to run. Plus, didn't somebody just offer you a pretty exciting job?
Me. Working for your father? Now that's a laugh.
You already work for my father.
Oh, yeah.
Plus, you've got one more ace up your sleeve.
Yeah, what would that be?
Me. Wherever you go, I am there right by your side.
For sure?
For sure.
Don't take much to be a dreamer. All you do is close your eyes. Just a made-up world on you. Never seen. It's finally open, and my dreams, they're average size. But they don't much matter if you ain't with me.
Well, Jack, are you in or are you out?
Here's a headline, Newsies on a mission, kill the competition, sell the next edition. We'll be out there, carrying the banner, see us out there, carrying the banner, always out there, carrying the banner. Look at me, I'm the king of New York. Suddenly, I'm respectable, staring right at you.